screams, I eat pussy. It just screams that. And that's okay. I want it to scream that so the women can flock to my cottage cabin and I can put flowers in their hair or something.
It'll be so easy, you know? Like, they might think you're a witch because of the time period, but, like, you can get a lot of women before you get sunk to the bottom of the ocean. Welcome to Queer Talk, guys, number one podcast to connect you to all of your favorite queer creators. Space where we share our stories on all things queer related. And hey, if you're new listening to this and you're not subscribed, what you're doing, baby, hit that subscribe button and give us a follow on Spotify. We have a fucking awesome guest today. She just had a sound completely fucking blow up. If you haven't heard it, you're not on TikTok.
For real, like, oh my God.
Yes. Please welcome Arriah. Did I say that right?
Yes, you did say it right. Okay. Thank you so much.
I should have probably asked you before I recorded.
No, you got it. You went balls to the wall. You said, I'm going to try, and that's good.
Yes. All right. If you guys don't know who Raya is, she's Ushy Gushy Squish on Instagram. Exactly how I said it. That's how you can look her up. She's a queer TikToker. And I've been following her. I've been following you for a long time now, probably since I got on TikTok back in quarantine. Like, you're one of, like, the OGs that I followed because you kept coming up on my page.
Oh, God. I'm so glad I'm an OG. Like, I'm glad I was here when it all started. Like,
you're an O-fucking-G. But it was funny because I started hearing that sound that blew up, and it sounded familiar. Because I'm like, oh, like, and it just kind of, like, in the back of my mind, you know, like, getting on a TikTok, like, randomly. And I was like, okay, like, this is a little too familiar. And so I went and I saw the original one and I was like, oh my God, one of us. I'm like, one of us, we made it.
No, yeah, a lot of my friends, like, were hearing the sound before they even knew it was me. And I, like, when I did the video and posted it, I did not expect, like, I thought it was just funny. I was like, I'm dicking around before work. I'm just chilling in my car. And all of a sudden I come back on break and it's blowing up and my friends are texting me and they're like, this person's using your sound. This person's using your sound. It was surreal. I was very taken aback by it.
Yeah. I was fucking pumped for you. I was pumped for the community. I'm like, damn, one of the people in the community sound went viral.
Like, no, for real. I was like, wow, like, they better watch out. LGBTQ community is going to take over TikTok.
We're coming up in the game, okay? October is the new fucking June.
Exactly. We didn't get a Pride Month. We might as well just turn the rest of the year into a whole Pride Month.
Yeah, or at least the spookiest time of the year, right?
Exactly. I mean, devils to some people. We might as well really act like them.
How much gayer can you get? Might as well just
change. Exactly.
Well, that's awesome, dude. That's super fucking cool. I also wanted to kind of talk, because, like, you do a lot of videos, like, before work, and you, like, talk about, you know, corporate life and shit like that. And, like, I related to that super hard because I also work for a big, you know, corporate company. Yeah. In sales, and it's brought about a lot of shit. Like, I feel like just everything that's gone on with this summer and the events that have happened have completely changed my views on so many things and, like, my thoughts surrounding, like, capitalism. And you talk about it, and I don't know about you, and, like, I don't know how you grew up, but, like, for me, capitalism was number one. You work your ass off, and if you take a day off, you better be fucking dead, you know?
Yeah.
That's how it is.
Yeah, my parents are kind of the same. Like, my mom, you know, has worked her ass off to get to where she's at, and she has instilled in me to work my ass off. But, like, at a point in time, it's just like you're burning yourself out. You're working for a corporation that could replace you in a heartbeat. If you die tomorrow, they have someone to take your spot and they don't care.
Yeah.
And it comes to a point where you're just like, what are you living for the money from people who don't even know your name, or are you living for yourself?
Yep.
And I think that's so much more important to look at than to look at how much money you can bring in. As long as you're comfortable and you're living and you're healthy, you know, I think that's what really people need to put into perspective.
I completely agree. I was feeling the same way, and I didn't even realize, like, my thought processes around it until I started following people who were anti-capitalism, at least anti-capitalism in the US, and with just, like, the BLM movement and how it capitalizes on oppression, not just of Black, Indigenous, people of color, but also the queer community, anybody that is in some sort of minority. And I just was like, what the fuck? Like, it just all like spread open. And I was like, how did I not know about this? I had a conservative upbringing. I was not in an area where there was any diversity. Like, it took me a fucking long time to like get that information and get that knowledge. And once I heard like about that, it, everything just kind of came into focus. Like, you know, when it's like, who are we going to, like the corporations, who, what are we going to pick? Are we going to pick Black Lives Matter? Are we going to pick Pride? Are we going to pick, you know, like that whole thing? And I'm just like,
oh, everything is so performative. When all that came into play, because I wasn't very educated on capitalism either until recently. You know, I went throughout my whole life not understanding I was even a minority.
Yeah.
So finding out all that stuff and how under what America works under, I'm viewed as the complete bottom of the barrel, like nothing. It was crazy. And then I looked, after looking into capitalism, I looked into consumerism, how that plays such a big part into capitalism, and how we feel like we want all these things because of the conditioning of the upbringing that America has taught us, because the more money you spend, the higher the corporations, and the more the 1% is above everybody and controlling everything. And so it kind of makes you rethink your whole lifestyle.
Yeah.
It was very, it was a very big 180 for me when I figured all that stuff out.
What was it like for you kind of thinking, because like you touched on, you know, that you weren't really realizing how oppressed, you know, Black people were and all of these things, probably because our education system sucks ass and doesn't teach us that. But like, did it make you feel like guilty at all? That you're like, oh my God, I had no idea. Or like, what were those like emotions that, cause like, I'm sure like we have a lot of listeners that are like diverse. So I'm sure like they would love to hear like your kind of thought process.
I really didn't feel guilty. And I don't know if that's what I should have felt to some people, but that doesn't matter. I more just felt like I had this whole part of my soul that was like hidden from me this whole time.
Yeah.
Cause after learning that everything about that, things affect me a lot differently now. Like, when I was younger and Trayvon Martin passed, and I was talking to my white mom about it, someone who has no clue about my struggle, and I don't, you know, she doesn't say anything out of malice, but as, she doesn't understand that, and she didn't know what to tell her Black daughter. So growing up, I had no idea of that, and then getting that to hit me at this age, especially now that I'm an adult and moving in a world where people don't view me as a child anymore, I don't get that benefit anymore. Like, I feel this strong connection to these souls now. I feel like Breonna Taylor, I wear her name every single day, and I feel, and I shouldn't feel like I know her as a sister, but I feel like I do. Like, I feel like that was my best friend, or that was even me at some times. Like, and I never would have had that connection years ago, and I'm thankful for it, but also it pains me because things affect me a lot differently now. Like, things trigger me, my fight or flight mode when it comes to my skin tone.
You know, I think it's part of just coming to terms with something that you, like you said, was hidden, right? And it comes all at once, and it can be overwhelming, you know? And like, I don't think, you know, you shouldn't feel guilty or anything. Like, I mean, you can feel whatever you want to feel, but I think that it's definitely something that kind of like coming out and not realizing and having to deal with all of those emotions. I mean, I'm sure it is different, but maybe within the same vein a little bit, just in terms of like, oh my God, there's just part of me that I was suppressing and now like I'm coming into my own and stuff like that.
That's a really good way to explain it. That's kind of a little bit what it felt like, realizing that I'm extremely marginalized being a Black woman and part of the LGBTQ community. Like, I'm completely looked at differently, and I never noticed, you know, it is a lot like coming out and coming to terms with I'm different. And I'm viewed different.
I felt that way too, like in the summer with all of that stuff that was going on with BLM and things like that. Like you said, there's so many levels to racism. You know, I thought that I was this woke white person, and not like woke, like I talked about and like all this stuff, but like internally I was like, oh yeah, like I'm in a good spot. You know what I mean? Like, I'm not racist. Like, I'm not this, like my parents, you know, all this stuff. And there's levels to it that you might not even be aware of, you know? And that was something that I had to deal with. And I also, things with, you know, the Trump administration and privatizing, you know, letting private adoption agencies turn away gay couples. Like, when some of that stuff happened with, like, the ban on trans people being in the military and stuff like that, like, it didn't affect me as much But that did, even though it's not directly affecting me, like I'm not adopting right now. Yeah. But the fact that that could affect me and it's affecting people in my community, like you said, like even though Breonna Taylor isn't somebody that's close to you, she is close to you because it could be, it could have been you. It could have been a family member. Like, you know, like there are people that are being turned away right now. Like that could have been me. It could have been a family member. It could have been this.
And, exactly.
And, so, and obviously that's a very mild thing. It's not life or death, but it's a very milder version. I'm not going to compare it to people being shot and killed, but like in the same vein.
Yeah.
Just not, you know, life or death, but.
Yeah. Racism is extremely, I think a lot of white people don't notice because it's embedded into you. I think it's embedded into the generational trauma. I think it's so many years of just whiteness that is just embedded into these children and is shown. Mm-hmm. And people say things like when people say, you know, I don't see color, that's not racist, but it is in a sense. And white people will not recognize that because in their lives they've never been oppressed. They can't explain that. And I think that's what a lot of people need to unpack is that as a white person, there's certain things you'll never understand. And it's okay to say that you don't understand it.
Yeah.
But what matters is that you try to prevent it.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Exactly. Well, the I don't see color thing really pisses me off because it's like, if you're fucking blind, maybe you can say that. Like legitimately, maybe you can say that. You're literally colorblind, but still you can see shades. So you know that there's a black
you
person there.
You can't even say that.
You know what I mean? Like melanin is shades. It's fucking shades. It's not like green people and purple people.
I'm gonna use that. I'm gonna be like, are you blind? You can't say that. Cause like,
no.
Cause the thing is like, we don't want you to not see our color. We want you to see it and love it and respect it just as much as you would your own.
Exactly.
Like, embrace it. It's not that hard. Embrace it. Like, I love my blackness. I don't want you not to see it.
Man, I fucking hate that. My grandparents like, say that. I'm like, you're not blind yet.
Come on, Paul. I know you see color. I know you bought that ugly red sweatshirt. Come on. Come on. Shit.
Oh my God, that's so funny. But like, yeah, I mean, capitalism just preys on that stuff. And like, I think it just like, it, for me, like it was a work ethic thing. Like, I need to be working this many hours to seek validation from my parents. And I'm like a hard worker and I work really hard and I am doing more than I'm supposed to be doing. And like, and like I'm climbing up the ladder of success. And
that's
happy and stuff. And I realized that that is fucking bullshit.
It is. My mom used to yell at me all the time because I would quit jobs like that. The minute I was no longer happy with the job or where I was at, I would quit. And, you know, she was like, you can't do that. And I was like, I have every right to. I refuse in this lifetime, in this vessel, to overwork it and burn it out, to live some extravagant lifestyle that isn't necessary, you know? Like, I think only Gen Z will ever understand what I mean, but. Yeah. I know they're mostly listening, so I get it.
Gen Zs are listening. Millennials are jealous. I think we're the only ones that are like, we actually like Gen Z. Like millennials, like I like Gen Zs. Like they're fucking awesome.
Exactly.
They're like, so I fucking think woke.
We're so cool. I'm like, you want to spit in a cop's face? Go off, sis. Yes. Like, do that shit.
Yeah. Like that's some that's respect. Like
exactly. You're 18 and you're trying to overthrow the government, girl. Nothing but respect for my soldiers.
Yes. Yeah. That shit is crazy. It does. It stems from that, like, you know, consumerism and like constantly buying shit. And that's like the whole basis of our country.
Yeah,
and like,
we put so much money.
Yeah. So much money into it, and it's just, it's a lie.
It's crazy how much money people spend. Like, oh my God.
Yeah, it is a lot. I just moved to a new place, and it's uncomfortable how much money I've spent just because I had to move and I had to buy furniture.
Exactly. Just because you had to live in a shelter, you had to spend an arm and a leg for what?
Yeah.
So you could sustain life. That's literally it. Like,
yeah. Do you consider yourself like a minimalist?
Oh, shit. No, I'm trying so hard to be. I want to be
it's
so
hard.
Bad. It's so difficult.
Buying is fun. Consuming is fun.
Especially like when you're sad. You're like, that new cup is going to make me feel better about my life.
Yeah.
Like.
It really is. It really does though. Like I've done that. Like I moved, but I was also like sad, like like getting over someone when it was happening. And so I was like, oh, let me buy this. And I like justified it. Cause I'm like, I need curtains for my French doors and I need fucking sheer curtains for over there. And I need a rug and I need this. And you know, I thought I got a kitten too. I gotta get shit for the kitten. Like
we gotta get 18 toys. Like I have a kitten now.
Literally, I bought her way too many toys. She plays with them, which is nice. She's playing with them right now. But I usually don't like that. But like, I got really into minimalism a few years ago when I graduated college, and I was like, sold a bunch of shit, and I like traveled for 6 months, and I was like, if I can live out of a 70 liter backpack and I only use 80% of that, why the fuck do I need anything else?
Yeah. That's exactly what went through my head. Like, I would just look at all, like, I still have too many clothes, but a couple months ago, I just went through all my clothes one day and threw like two trash bags out because I was like, I just have so much stuff. But then 2 days ago, I bought a new bong because I was like, it'll make me feel better about my life. I was like, it'll make me feel like I'm smoking better, cleaner or something. I don't know.
Like, yeah, I mean, you don't have to, like, it's already comes clean. So exactly, it comes clean, it's fresh.
Like, I was like, I don't want to clean my other one. It's too much work, blah. But like, retail therapy is such a thing and it's so engraved in us in commercials. Like, commercials use so much psychology to sell their products that works. And I won't lie, it works on me. And I think the problem with like minimalist is like people think you have to in one day throw everything away and like only have one bowl and one spoon and live in the back of your car and you don't. It's very much of a process and we have emotional ties to so many things and it's about breaking that and realizing it's a thought in our head.
It is. Like, you gotta see, does this bong make me value? Is it value in my life? Keep it. Does this cup make me happy? I don't fucking like this cup. I'm gonna throw it away. I'm gonna get a new cup.
Exactly. I'm gonna give this cup to someone who will use it and value it because I cannot.
Thrift the cup. Like, I do feel better when I thrift. I've been thrifting a lot, so I feel better that I'm not consuming new things. I'm consuming and I'm like reusing. That makes me feel better about consuming because then you can consume and feel good. And then you can also feel like, okay, well, I'm also not like really getting into consumerism as well.
Exactly. Like, you never have to not buy anything again, but like I try to, you know, buy more sustainably or not buy fast fashion. I do mainly thrifting, I think. But then, you know, it's harder because sustainable fashion, we're not used to those prices. You know, fast fashion was, I spent like $40 on 3 pairs of panties. I was like, I would have gotten 10 at Pink.
And they get you.
Like, and it's horrible because the reason they're so cheap is because they're made in sweatshops and it's just, that bad energy going into that clothing and then you wearing it. It's not good.
And the people who care about wearing sustainable things and doing that don't have the money because they don't like to participate in capitalism. And so it's just like this fucking cycle.
Like, it's gotten to the point where I'm like, I'm going to just learn how to sew my own clothes because I can't afford sustainable fashion and fast fashion is horrible. So I'm just going to have to go back to the pilgrim days and make my own shit. Like, I've been drawing up designs and everything. Like, I just have to learn at this point.
Hey, make a log cabin in the woods. Go to the market. Make a cottage.
Make a garden.
Club. Another club. Another club.
Exactly. Go off the grid. Like, this is a whole scheme, a plan.
It really is. It's very gay.
No, it is so, it screams, I eat pussy. It just screams that. And that's okay. I want it to scream that so the women can flock to my cottage cabin and I can put flowers in their hair or something.
It'll be so easy, you know? Like, they might think you're a witch because of the time period, but, like, you can get a lot of women before you get sunk to the bottom of the ocean.
Exactly. I mean, we got it. We've done figured it out.
Oh, man. Okay, so have you seen, because it just made me think of Coven, which made me think of Sarah Paulson.
Yes.
Have you seen Ratchet yet?
I watched a couple episodes of it and she already ate that shit up. Ate it.
Yes.
I could cry thinking about that woman.
Like, I'm obsessed with her. I've been obsessed with her since American Horror Story. And this was even before it came out. So obviously that was who else was obsessed was with Sarah Paulson if you're not gay? That's just terrible. It's awful.
She was literally such, when I found out she had a wife, that's when I succumbed to her power. I bowed down to her at my altar and I was like, wow, queen. Yes. Like, I knew you had flavor.
Oh yeah. I mean, Holland Taylor, like, who? How can I compete with that?
Like, a straight person can't act like Sarah Paulson. They can't.
No. Nope.
She has range.
She does. She has such range. I absolutely love, and I've seen her old stuff, like before American Horror Story, before she was really famous. Mm-hmm. Like, she played like small roles. I forget, there was one where she played and it was like the two main characters were like mentally disabled. And mm-hmm. she played a sister that wasn't out yet, but was like trying to come out. And I was like, there it is. Like, there's her, like the first queer character she
That's
played.
That's the feeling. Like, yes. I get it. She just bodies it. And then finding out like she's queer in real life, I was like, oh, you fucking queen.
Yes.
I was like, oh, I will give you my money. Like, that woman, and she's just gorgeous. Everything about her is just so chic and wonderful. She's never done anyone wrong.
And it sucks because she goes for older women. And I'm like,
right?
Aw, you don't want to like try and play like 20 years
for
younger?
Real?
I'm your girl. Like, just like, I'm your girl.
It's sick. I was like, no. Like, I can be a gilf. I can be a gilf. I promise. Yeah. Give me a, like, black don't crack very easily, sis, but give me a couple fucking years. Like, come on. I would kiss the ground she walks on. Jesus, love her.
I mean, okay, this sounds really shitty, but you know what? Holland Taylor's getting up there. She's like in her 80s. I mean, God rest her soul. She's awesome, but yeah. She will pass away soon.
Like, she's great. Love her, queen. But like, you need someone to replace her. You need a second wife. Like, I know you grieving, baby.
Raya's going to be there. She's going to be there to pick up the pieces of Sarah
exactly.
Paulson.
Exactly. I'm going to swoop in. She's going to be so happy.
She's going to be so devastated. She's going to go on TikTok. And then she's going to see, you're going to be on the For You page, one of the first people on there. And she's going to be like, that's my bitch.
Exactly. She's going to be like, my fucking girl. And that's when I'll know I made it.
That's the fucking
not us, like, fangirling over Sarah Paulson.
Oh, I know. My editor, Elise, she's one of my good friends. She hears me talk about Sarah Paulson or Portrait of a Lady on Fire almost every single episode. She goes, you know, you don't have to drag it on. And I'm like, but I'm talking about this to a new person every week. So this is a new conversation for this person. It's not for you, but it is for
exactly.
me.
Exactly. This is new energy. Like, I'm coming in hot. Stop yeah. playing with me. For real.
So you're a femme girl. You like femme, you're a femme on femme relationship, right?
Yes. Yes, 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 yes.
We love the femmes.
Love femme girls. It's so hard to get them.
They're very interesting.
They're so fucking interesting, let me tell you. Oh my god.
What I've noticed though, because I'm definitely into femmes as well. Like, I'd say tomboy to all the way to femme, but like,
yeah.
Man, I feel like usually the femmes are more masculine in terms of like no emotion, not crying as much, like that kind of thing. And I'm just like, oh, like, I'm like, do you want to talk about your feelings? Like,
you
how does that
so?
Make you feel? At least for me, my experiences, I don't know.
Mine are like the complete opposite. Like, they're the type for me, like, we hook up once and then they're hitting my phone for the next 3 days after I haven't answered. Ooh. And I'm like, hey, let's unpack that. Let's realize what we're doing. Let's talk about it. Yeah. Cause I'm not your girl. That's just how femmes are with me. But I like, they're just, like, they're so bad, but they're so bad. You know what I mean? Like,
they're bad, but they're bad.
Yeah. They're bad. But
like, what about the femmes on TikTok? What are your thoughts? Oh. The top femme, queer femmes on TikTok.
They're sexy.
Mm-hmm.
Let me say, they are very, very sexy. I can never remember like handles, but I follow a lot of, you know, femme queer girls, and they're so, and most of them like femmes. Like, it's very
That's
surprising.
Awesome.
Most of them will express that they like other femmes, and I'm just like, somehow I'm still alone. But that's not what.
It's okay, man. That's okay. That's another lie we're told too, is that
exactly.
you're only complete and happy when you're with someone else.
Right.
So.
I hate marriage is so relationships. They're just weird. I think relationships are so weird.
They very much are.
Like, it doesn't, I'm just supposed to take this random person and trust that they are not a horrible being, you know? Like, that's just so weird to me.
I know. I mean, because family's kind of off limits now, you know? Like,
right?
Families have been off limits for a couple hundred years. At some point, it was cool to, like, marry a cousin, and maybe you could have trusted them. But now you got to pick someone else.
Like, fuck, we can't go back? No, I'm playing.
You're saying I can't fuck my cousin? What the fuck?
God, the Republicans are so mad. Like, we were built off incest. You were built off incest. We
only
were
Kentucky
not.
And West Virginia.
Alabama's real pissed right now. But
just kidding, guys. If you guys are from those states,
exactly,
I'm
it's okay.
Kidding a little bit.
Yeah, you don't sleep with your cousin. No. We're not saying that.
Don't do that.
Don't do that.
Don't do that. Please don't do that. This is not the.
No.
I didn't know this. We were gonna get down this.
No, oh my God. Ready to get down to anything, girl.
Like, someone's like, well, if they said it, a TikToker said it. Oh, let's give it a try.
Well, you hear they're pushing their gay agenda. They're trying to fuck their cousins now. You hear this? You hear this, Rebecca? Like, they're gonna be so pissed.
You're going to hell.
Right.
Hey, we kissed when we were 5. Let's do it again at 17.
Oh God, this is great.
This is shit. This is the content people came here to get.
Right. I hope this is what people wanted to hear today.
We got some good stuff. Usually what I do is I pull a question, like a listener submitted question, and we answer it with unqualified advice on the podcast, just from experience and stuff like that.
Okay.
Yeah, you cool with that?
That sounds amazing. I would love to do that. Oh my God.
Yay.
I hope there's no incest questions advice, because that's what we were just talking about.
Yeah, I hope
so. That'd be real awkward.
Hey guys, just wanted to ask you, I'm really have a crush on someone.
I'm really interested in my cousin. How do I go about telling them? No.
I get a lot of those though, like, I'm in love with my best friend, how do I tell her? So it's like, I'm in love with my cousin, how do I tell her?
God, when people text me like, I'm in love with my best friend, how do I tell her? I'm like, girl, I don't know. I don't tell girls I have crushes on them. You're asking the wrong person. I am an Aquarius moon. I have no feelings. I don't tell people anything. Like,
oh, you're an Aquarius. Okay.
Aquarius moon, Aries sun. Okay, what are you?
I'm a Libra, Scorpio, Capricorn. I don't know what that means. What do you know? Do you know? Are you a Zodiac
Libra
person?
Sun?
Yeah.
Ooh.
Ooh, Libra.
No, like Libras. I love Libras so much. Like, Libras are so hot. They're great, but they're just like, oh, they're fuck boys from what I've seen. They can be fuck boys sometimes.
Yeah. Okay.
Talk your shit. Bite your lip. Queen, she said, yep. And what about it? What about it?
Big dick, same for big demeanor.
Period. Stop, because I'll start singing the whole song. We don't want that.
I know. Stop. The whole song. Stop. I don't know. I can't dance to it. My cousin literally taught me the dance. She's like a dancer, and she doesn't know the actual WAP. Like, she only knows that 15 seconds where it doesn't have anything like explicit.
Oh, yeah.
You know, and like my cousin Regan was like, well, I didn't know it was a bad song. She only heard the 15 seconds. And I was like, she's like, what does WAP stand for? I was like, stands for Women Against the Patriarchy.
Queen, yes. Women Against the Patriarchy. Yes. That's actually what they should rename it.
They should. And well, she was like, what does that mean? I was like, well, it's basically making it, you know, for women to be just as good as boys, or girls to be just as good as boys. And, you know, she was like, okay. And like went back to playing. And I was like,
perfect. Perfect. That's okay. All you had to tell her.
Oh, and I'm also, this is super weird. I have like Scorpio in like 5 different placements. I was told.
Oh God.
people don't even know until like they know me. And they fucking get the intensity. And they don't realize it. They're like, ah, shit.
I was going to say, you must be one passionate motherfucker to have Scorpio in 5 different.
Yeah.
Jesus Christ. I wouldn't be able to do it.
I didn't even realize how, like, passionate, intense. Not an intense way, like, I'm going to fucking burn shit and break up. You know what I mean? I'm not like that. I was when I was younger, like, 10 years ago.
Oh, good.
You know? Like, but not now. I'm not as, you know, I'm not
crazy. Destructive.
Yeah, I'm not destructive.
Yeah, you just feel things very hard.
Yeah, I do. Kind of. I really do.
Ooh.
It fucking sucks, too. It really does. Anyways.
Let me not talk about my trauma.
Yeah, let's not talk about the intensity and all the poem writing and, you know, let's not
the poems, baby, no.
Not the poems. back to this. All right, guys. Okay. So it's time for Question with the Queers. This is where we give our unqualified advice to a listener submitted question. And so this one is from Ryan. They're 20. They're from Alabama. And they write, "Hi, guys. I hope this gets picked for the podcast. I am having a dilemma, and I don't know who to go to, so you guys are my only hope. I have two friends. One friend I used to date. I came out, and she was my first girlfriend. The breakup was very intense and wasn't exactly amicable, but over time, we were able to be friends. She, however, during that time, dated our other friend. We will call her Kayla. And so now I have a crush on Kayla. They had previously ended. How do I navigate this?"
Oh, Lord.
So we have an ex and we have Kayla.
Okay. Well, who cares how the ex feels? They're an ex for a reason. Get your nut and go and do your thing. Like, you don't need approval. I mean,
get that bread, get that hand, and leave.
For real. If Kayla likes Ryan, I think Ryan in the clear. Maneuver your way into that cooch. Balls to the wall. If it doesn't happen, if X is mad about it, then X needs to unpack things within X itself. Because there's no reason X should be mad.
Yeah, I mean, if you guys are friends, like, maybe it wasn't, you guys didn't end amicably before, but since you guys, I mean, at least in this letter, I don't have a lot of detail from here, but it seems like you guys are friends. So are you guys really friends? Are you guys, like, frenemies, keeping each other close, yeah, but like there's still some shit, like you know, like with your friends too fast with your ex, but it's like not good, it doesn't make you feel good, you're jealous and you're anxious and whatever. Like, I would definitely have to see, like, you gotta ask yourself those things, like, are you jealous, are you constantly seeing what they're up to, like, do things still bother you, or are you completely finished and they're completely finished with you? And so, I mean, if you want to be a good friend and you're completely finished and you don't think they are, then yeah, maybe have a conversation and be like, "Hey, I like this person." And you know, regardless if, you know, they have a problem with it or not, it's kind of, you know, you got to own it. Like, if you want to do it, then do it, but deal with the repercussions of it. If it's something that you've done all your, checked all the boxes and you talked to them and it's been a while, then you got to do you. Or if that relationship is more important, you know, you just gotta really feel it out. But yeah, that's what I would do. Try to have a conversation and see if that friendship is worth even having. And if it is, you know, and this is even if this person likes you back. I don't even know if you know.
Yeah, we don't know that part.
We don't know. What if it's not
amicable? We really don't know. Like, what if this is not a mutual liking? What if this is all completely one-sided? Then we're talking about, how do you tell Kayla that you like her, but then also tell your ex that you like Kayla. Now we're dealing with two things we got to tell.
Yeah. What if everyone, you know what? Thruple. We'll just do a thruple and then we'll close the book.
Yeah. Yeah. Y'all just need to communicate and be like, yep, this is going to be a valid threesome, and just go with it. Go along with it. Do it.
Exactly.
You'll be so much happier. Peacemaker?
Be the peacemaker.
Exactly. That's what a Libra would do. Come on.
That's what a Libra. Don't put me on blast like that.
I mean, you said it, not me.
Oh, okay. Okay. Have I thought about that before? Yes. Have I done it? Yeah. No, I'm just kidding. Not a thruple. That shit's crazy.
I don't think I could do a thruple. I think that's too much commitment. Like, you're committing to two people. That's way too much.
Yeah, one queer person, we won't put gender into it, is enough. I mean, there's lots of talking, lots of emotions. I got Scorpio in five places. I can't believe myself, goddammit.
There's a lot to understand, like, and then, like, what bed are you guys getting to sleep in? Because I move around in my sleep. I cannot sleep with two other motherfuckers in the bed.
You need a California king.
Exactly, and who's affording that? Not us queers, that's for sure. We spend money on iced coffee and weed. We're not responsible. So
what you gotta do, you gotta sell the weed, you gotta be a small time dealer, get the Cali bed. That's what we gotta do.
No, for real, those are the three steps in queer success, guys. You heard it here first. Three steps in queer success: sell weed, make the money, get the Cali bed, and have a thruple. Period. That's how you win.
Man, I couldn't. I mean, that's like a hobby at that point. Like, I honestly, like I get like people who are polyamorous and non-monogamous. Like, I think it's super fascinating. I've dabbled with non-monogamy and non-exclusivity, and like, that's fine. But like, actually having like a 2-year relationship and a 3-month relationship, and you're hooking up with someone and you're casually dating someone, like, that's a hobby. Like, that's just not dating. Like, yeah, that's a fucking, like, that's a full-time job.
Yeah, like, at that point, I wouldn't even enjoy it, because who do you focus on at that point? You got to pick which one you're going to pay attention to, and then what if they're both having a bad day? Then what? Then what do you do? You're telling me you're going to please 2 queer people on a bad day?
Yeah, you're both on your period?
Yeah, no. Or all 3 of y'all? No, bye. I would probably beat 2 of them up. Like, I would not be going for it no more. Like, one gotta leave, or both y'all gotta leave. I don't know.
It was so funny, like, before I had you on here, like, I knew that you were chill as fuck, but I also knew you had this, like, super aggressive side, and I was like, damn, like, that's, like, it's a little intimidating. Like, that's some energy.
Thank you. I love hearing ladies say they're intimidated by me.
It's a compliment.
It's one of my favorite things.
I normally don't get intimidated as a Libra. I'm usually not intimidated by many people, and I was like, oh, she's intimidating, gotta get her on the podcast.
Yeah, I think it's my Aries that makes me so aggressive. I don't know, like, I'm very small in person, but I just be ready to fight at all times. Like, I'm not the type to argue. If you're gonna yell at me, like, do you want to fight, get in the street. Like, I'm not gonna waste my breath, seriously.
Can I hold your earrings or like your hair? Like, can I do something?
Oh no, I'll, yeah, I'll take my beanie off and you can hold that.
Sweet. I'll be like, you go, you get it. You yeah. You know what? We'll get pies after, maybe.
Exactly. You want me to grab you an iced coffee when you're done? You dehydrated? I got you. For real. You
wanna hold my beanie? I ordered online. We'll pick it up.
Exactly. Make sure we leave before she presses charges.
Hopefully you got some Nikes on. You can run.
I'll be out doing the dash out that bitch. For real. All
right, y'all. This is a lightning round. I'm gonna give Arriah some questions that she has to answer really fast. Are you ready?
Yep.
Yeah. Big spoon or little spoon?
Little spoon.
After we just talked about aggressive, I'll fucking fight you in the street.
The Libra has caught me being a simp. Oh my God.
Hold me in the Cali King bed.
You know what? I don't want to hear a goddamn thing, Libra. I don't want to hear it, because I bet you like it too.
You know what? Sometimes.
Exactly.
Sometimes.
Oh, unbalanced ass. Jesus Christ.
Are we about to kiss right now?
No, like, deadass, is this a first date or is this a podcast? Get it together. Get it fucking together. Let's go.
I'm sorry. Sometimes I don't know.
No, I lost track. Fuck. Okay.
Okay, back to the quick questions. Okay, Jasmine or Ariel?
Jasmine.
Have you ever worn socks with sandals?
Fuck yeah. It's a statement.
It is. Is it wrong for vegetarians to eat animal crackers?
No.
Okay. I just kind of want to argue. Can I just say no just to argue?
Yeah, you want to argue? We can argue.
Kidding. Climb a mountain or jump from a plane?
Climb a mountain.
Okay. Should I just put on or beat someone up? Should I do all three?
I'll beat someone up and then climb the mountain. Can I pick both?
Climb the mountain, push them off the mountain, climb back down the mountain.
I'm going to drag them up the mountain and then push them off the mountain.
Oh, shit. I'd watch it. I'd be like, you pissed her off.
Go, Raya. Go, go, go.
You can do it. You can do it. Hold your beanie. last song you listened to on repeat.
Lil Durk, Weirdo Hoes.
Okay. Giving presents or getting presents?
Neither.
Oh, damn. Never had that before.
Yeah,
trying to fuck this podcast up, Raya. Jesus,
you know, I'm different. My buddy different.
I've never had someone say neither. So you just don't like presents in general? You don't like giving them? You don't like getting them? Is it like a source of anxiety?
I don't know. I feel like half the time people don't really get me shit I like, so I really don't see the point, and I don't really feel like buying material things for people is very, like, some people like it, but I feel like that's not my love language really. Mm-hmm. So I don't really do it.
All right. Gift giving. Not on the love language list.
All right. Just making sure you knew.
So. Yeah. Oh my God. Okay. last song you listened to on repeat. Wait, I already gave you that one. Oh my God. You're getting me all, you're getting me all worked up.
Are you flustered?
Favorite queer movie.
Fuck, Below Her Mouth. It's the sex scenes. The sex scenes get me every time.
I know. The movie as a whole is pretty shitty, but the sex scenes are amazing. Like, they're really good.
And both of them
are
so hot.
They really
are. They're so fucking sexy. Like, I can't help it. The movie sucks, but the sex scenes were 10 out of 10. I'm pretty sure they were real, too.
They had some chemistry. Hopefully, we like to think it was off screen too.
In one of those scenes, their vaginas were touching. You can't tell me otherwise.
I know. I don't know how they could have not. I don't honestly don't know how they do sex scenes, especially when they're so raw. Like, how are you not physically exchanging fluids?
Fucking like on camera.
Yeah. I like, do you put like a tiny towel that you can't see? Like, is there makeup involved?
I feel like maybe they like put take spirit gum, that sticky stuff, and they like glue the vagina and then put makeup over it so nothing can. I don't know. That was a stretch though.
Like what is it? Like the female condom or whatever, and they like just slap her on. I don't even know how that works.
They put a piece of duct tape over it just so nothing can get in or out. Ooh, that's horrible. I hope they're not doing that to the actors.
Yeah. I think you might as well just do the real thing if you're going to put
exactly. You might as well just become be a porn star while as an actress. Be a multitasker.
It's going down on OnlyFans. I have a friend who she has like 300 or 400K or something on TikTok, and she's verified, and she has OnlyFans, and she's making like 10 to 15K a month. No joke.
Yeah, my friend, he's on OnlyFans, and he makes so much money. It's ridiculous. It almost makes me sick to my stomach how much money he makes and how much stuff he writes off on his taxes on OnlyFans, because they know they found out they can do that, and now they're going balls to the wall.
Oh yeah, anything that you buy that's for your business, you can write off.
For real, he bought himself a nice new ring light and wrote it off. I was like, oh, you bastard!
You literally can. You can write off your Wi-Fi. You can. Now I'm getting all technical because like I've done travel stuff in the past, mm-hmm. and so like you can write your square footage of your home off, like your home office.
For real.
You can, like, your cell phone, like, everything.
I love that OnlyFans blew up. I think it makes it so much more comfortable for sex workers, though. Like, and the money they make from it is great. Like, if you can sustain life off that, amazing. Go off, girl.
Yeah, my friend was a server. She's like,
for real.
She makes so much more money. She made more money just, like, the first time she posted, you know? Yeah. Made, like, $400 in a day.
Yeah, and servers already make pretty good money. So to make more money than you would be doing serving, like, that's a successful go off.
Yeah, I love it. I think it is. It's making sex work more accessible, which is making it more, like, assimilating into culture, not being as taboo. Even though everybody is on Pornhub and everybody is looking up
for
naked
real.
Shit. I mean, I guess unless you're ace or, like, you're asexual or something like that.
Yeah, but like, even then, like, everyone is watching it. And even back, like, in the old times, like, prostitutes and sex workers have been around for years. I mean, even in the ancient Egypt times, they were around. So this is not a new profession. This is not women disrespecting their bodies. If anything, I find it to be women taking back hold of their bodies.
It is. People, like, when the Wild Wild West was a thing, I, like, saw this on, like, some documentary. Like, the women were the ones that had the money. The sex workers that had all of the money, because the people who would go to those Wild Wild West towns, they didn't have mm-hmm. shit. And they were just, like, mm-hmm. workers. Like, these just dumb dudes who just would work in the mines and then spend all their money to have sex with these women. And so these women had all of the power. I mean, it sucks because, like, STDs and shit like that. They didn't have the medication and stuff. But they had so much money. They, like, created a lot of things in those communities out west because they were the ones mm-hmm. that had money. Isn't that nuts?
For real. Like, that is crazy to think. And now it's gotten to the point where you don't even have to sleep with anyone to make money for it.
Yeah.
Like, we really have made it free range. You don't have to be with another person. You don't have to risk STD.
No.
Like, do a little dance.
Yeah, do a little dance.
Some people will pay for your feet. Exactly. Yeah. Go off. Do whatever you want.
I've always thought I don't think I want to have my own OnlyFans, but like I would love to be in someone else's OnlyFans. That's some Libra shit. I literally think about that. That I'm like, is, if someone wanted me to, I would totally be in it.
That is such a fucking Libra thing. Like, I wouldn't do it, but if someone offered me to, I would do it. Like, are you daring me to? I'll do it. For real, where's the mask
at? I don't even need a dare, man. I don't even dare.
I just need a simple proposal.
Yeah. Someone be like, hey, you want to be in it? I'd be like, I do. Yep. I really, really do.
Need details? Nope.
No, I don't need alcohol either.
Turn the camera on.
I can figure it out.
Sober. She can do it sober.
Sober beyond OnlyFans. Oh, God. I think I hope my parents don't listen to this podcast. I think that's it for the questions. We went off on a tangent. Thank you so much for being on this podcast /date/podcast/podcast.
Of course. I was gonna say date / I don't know. Ship us?
Yeah, do you guys ship us? If you guys enjoyed this episode, please drop us a rating on Apple Podcasts. Leave us a little written review. That's it for this episode, my queers. Thank you for listening and subscribing. If you're not subscribed, hit that subscribe button. Give us a follow on Spotify. Thank you so much, Arriah, for humoring me being on this podcast. You guys like this, you can find her at Ushy Gushy Squish on TikTok. And what are your social for?
My Instagram handle is a.rriah, and my Snapchat is arriah.b0815.
There we go. You guys can find me on all platforms at Bree Logan. Be you, be queer, stay safe. We will see you on the next episode.